Hi, Moffitt Mustangs. Mrs. Trigueros, your principal here with my co-host, Miss Feliciano. How are you today, Miss Feliciano?
I'm doing great. Happy Monday, everybody.
Yes, happy Monday. We are excited about our video this week, but before I get started with that, Miss Feliciano, I have so many shout outs to give. I'm really excited about. First of all, the entire class of Mrs. Cowan's third grade, they have all been doing excellently when I spoke with Mrs. Cowan last week on their iReady. So way to go, Mrs. Cowan's class, on your iReady. You are being responsible learners. So from Mrs. Wharton's class, Kirsten has been very responsible, participating and working hard. Way to go. Ansu from Mr. Santana's class, very responsible learner. Nevaeh from Mrs. Hernandez's class, she is so kind and respectful to others. So what a wonderful trait. Thank you, Nevaeh. And in Mrs. Delgado's fifth grade class, we have Marcus, who is being very responsible in his learning. And we have Lynette in Mrs. Cueto Sanchez's second grade class, who's also being responsible. Virginia and Isaac from Mrs. Vargas's kindergarten class have been responsible learners and they participate. Well done. And that really, it gets us into our focus for this week, Ms. Feliciano, on setting goals for 2021. We did talk about this, didn't we, Ms. Feliciano? Back in December, we talked about setting goals.
Yes, we did. We went over how to set a goal, right? The whole process behind it. And today we're going to go into focusing on a couple of specific goals that we can start off with here in 2021.
I love it. And we're going to do it as a whole school. So here we go. We get to, first of all, we all know that iReady, our goal, and we have iReady goals, right? We've said from the beginning of school that we have 45 minutes every single week that we expect you to do your iReady reading and 45 minutes a week in math. Now, some of you do more than that, which is awesome, but we want to continue with that goal. Now, today starts our iReady diagnostic number 2 in reading. And so we have to have a goal. So students, those are our three goals. You need to try your best on the test, do the test by yourself, like we talked about in our assembly back on Friday. It's not for your parents. It's for you to do your best. And they'll say, just do your best. And listen, I have an exciting announcement. If you go up 15 or more points in kindergarten through second grade, or at least 10 points or more in third through fifth grade, and or go green, we are going to send you a special postcard and a little prize in the mail because we thought that would be fun. Isn't that cool, Ms. Feliciano?
That's really cool. I hope you guys really reach this goal.
So when you do your test, work hard on it. Don't rush through. You want to get the answers correct. And again, if it's hard, you can have growth mindset. You can do it. You just try your best. It's okay. And remember, it needs to be you, students, who are working on it, because if somebody helps you, then it might be too hard. And we love iReady because it really helps you learn just right at your level. Isn't that cool, Ms. Feliciano?
That's really cool.
So let's go to goal number 2.
Well, goal number 2 is that we are going to make a goal to be responsible learners, okay? And there's a few things that you need to do to be a responsible learner. You need to attend all your Zoom sessions every single day, okay? Every single Zoom session every day.
Right. There's three, right, Ms. Feliciano? So there's three Zoom sessions to attend each day. And that was one of our goals that we did set forth in December, but we want to continue that all through 2021. But the other thing is you want to complete all of your assignments on Seesaw and on Schoology and any of the other assignments that you have going on. So next, we want to be engaged and participate. Ms. Feliciano, are you there?
I'm still here. I'm listening.
Oh, okay. I couldn't tell because you have your camera off.
No, but I can hear you. I can hear what's going on.
But see, I want to keep you safe and know that you're really paying attention, because even when I called you, you didn't respond right away. So that's our last goal, that we want to keep our cameras on. And that way your teachers know that you're being engaged and participating. Thank you, Ms. Feliciano, because did you see how it was hard to see if Ms. Feliciano was really paying attention? So that's really important, students, that you leave your camera on at all times, okay? So last, we have our goal. Is goal number three is to care for others.
Yes, and especially, you know, lately we've been going through some difficult times, a lot of us, okay? And we're all going through it. So we need to make sure that we care for each other. And, you know, every single day, a simple act of kindness can make a big difference for others. And I know some of our shout outs we had earlier, you know, some of the teachers reported that some of those students are really caring for each other, really caring for others. So we're going to talk about this more next week, actually. But we really want to pay attention to how others are feeling and show that we care.
I love that. And Moffitt Mustangs, all of our students, staff, teachers, all of us are very caring of each other. And we're so grateful to have that community here at Moffitt. So make it a goal to spread kindness and love every day. So our three goals, number one is do your best on your iReady diagnostic and do it by yourself. Don't rush, take your time. But do your best. And then also with iReady, 45 minutes a week in reading and 45 minutes a week in math. Goal number two is to be responsible learners during class. So during Zoom sessions, leave your camera on, be engaged and participate. And our last goal is to care for others. So think about one way that you can care for somebody today and every day to spread that kindness. So it was so great to see you. It was so wonderful to see you again, Ms. Feliciano. Thank you for being my wonderful partner. And we will see you next time. Bye.
Bye.